Hello and welcome to Empire of War Games. My name is Eplesh and today I'm going to talk a little bit about the most recent news. Over the next couple of days I will upload more videos talking about more previews, all the news that were released in the recent days, and I will just ramble on about them, talk a little bit about them and give you my opinions. Okay, so as you have probably seen in the video or in the thumbnail, today I'm going to talk about the new Orc models, specifically the Beast Snaggers. Those were previewed over the last couple of weeks. We had the Squishhawk Boy previewed to us weeks ago, and recently we had the Beast Snagger Boy. And a lot of people are asking what my opinion is on them. And actually, there is a lot to talk about here, even though they just previewed two models, which is not a lot. Oh, and we had a full video with other previews, probably hinting on another model or two or three. And yeah, let's talk about them. So first up, they started and introduced the Beast Snaggers with a video. In there, they showed like walls with tribal markings and paintings. And in there, we saw different models. And I think all of those were basically previews for the previews. And there will probably be another orc boss. There will be a vehicle pulled by squigs and so on. Now, first up, what are the Beast Snaggers? Beast Snaggers are nomadic orcs who have a disdain for armored vehicles and instead use many variations of squigs to battle. They aim to hunt the largest creatures and machines, ranging from tanks and monsters to even titans. They come predominantly from the Snakebites clan due to their appreciation for the old ways and their disregard for more complex technology, although they can be found across the entire spectrum of orc society. Due to them spending most of their lives hunting the largest beast they can find, they are hulking mountains of muscle, even for orc standards. While they are not as durable as a knob, they can hit just as hard. Beast Snaggers Gretchen are affectionately dubbed Saddle Gits, and are a smidge braver than most members of their species. And the last two sentences are what got people either excited or very, very scared. Now, why would that be? It's simple. I think you guessed it. The last descriptions, while not as durable as a knob, they can hit just as hard. And the Beast Snagger Gretchen are affectionately dubbed Saddle Gits and are a smidge braver than most members of the species. Basically sounds we are getting Primaris Gretchen and Primaris Orc boys in this case. And that's weird for most because, yeah, why are we getting new orcs and why aren't they just regular boys? Why do they have to be Beast Snaggers and so on? And I think GW are going the same route they went with Space Marines. They know a lot of people like the old Orc Boys model. They appreciate how cheap it is for GW standards. They appreciate the models. They just like them. People have full armies of them and they don't want to make them obsolete just like that. Orc Boys have been a thing for very, very long. I don't know how old the kit is in specific, but I know that it's been there in Assault on Black Reach. That's when I started getting into Warhammer. So it's at least like what, 12 years old, 13 years old. And GW just decided, let's throw Primaris Orcs in there and just give them new models that are stronger and just better in every way. And they cost a little bit more, like points wise. And also probably money wise. And that's it. And all other people can just use their old orcs, and everyone who just jumps into orcs like in a year or so or in a couple of months, I guess, can buy the new ones. That's it. Simple as that. And GW thinks that's the correct way to handle these kinds of situations. They want to introduce new things along the old stuff and then replace it. And it's exactly what they are going to do here. I don't think Beast Snaggers will be the entire range, obviously, because we had vehicles, new orc vehicles released not too long ago, and Beast Snaggers are not known for their vehicles, but I can see the regular Beast Snagger boy replacing the regular orc boy because they don't look any different. The only thing that makes it look more Beast Snaggery compared to regular orc boy is the outfit, especially the spikes on its back or on its shoulders. And all you will have is the option to decide if you want to go a squig heavy army for your cavalry, I guess, or vehicles, or if you want to go for traditional vehicles with your trucks and whatever else you have, your bikes. And that's how GW plans to diversify all these things. Now, keep in mind, I'm just talking about it. I'm theorizing. Nothing is sure as of the date of recording the video. But yeah, even the Gretchen are getting primarized, so they are not going to be stronger or anything. And I doubt they will cost more points, to be honest, for one leadership more. But yeah, I'm interested to see how they will look like. Now, what I would be interested to know from you is, what do you think about my theory that they are just introducing new models alongside the old ones and then just phase the old ones out in like 5 years or something? And yeah, and they just do that. Do you think that's the better way? Do you think that just like replacing the old models just like that would be the better way? I would be really interested to know what you think about that. I know a lot of Orc players, and Orc players are very attached to their models because, you know, painting 120 Orc boys is... you can, you know, speed paint them, but a lot of people still get attached because 120 Orcs is like hundreds and hundreds of hours, even with speed painting. So just throwing them out the window is not the best idea. So I'm actually agreeing with GW on this idea. If Beast Snaggers are just an add-on, like Militarum Tempestus for Imperial Guard, I'm not sure how I would feel about that. A lot of people would probably find that better. Just, you know, you can take a Beast Snagger detachment and get bonuses, or you can play regular Orcs and then just have like a Squeakhawk Boy squad in there just because they are good rules-wise or something. That would be fine. That would be probably the best compromise for everyone. But I think we need to advance the model lines and so on, especially for Elder and stuff. So, yeah, it's a difficult topic. They didn't introduce new models alongside the Necrons, just to reiterate on that real quick, because previously there were not a lot of Necron players. Let's be honest here. And even if they were, they are not mad at all at GW, you know, replacing the Necron Warriors kit or anything, because you paint like 40 of them, or in the current meta, I guess 60, and you're done. And yeah, just replacing them is super painless. In case of replacing Orcs and Space Marines, those are like two of the most played factions, I would guess. And a lot of people have painted a shit ton of Orcs, and just, you know, throwing them out the window like that, just out of an announcement, would be very strange. So yeah, it's a very complex topic. I would be very interested to hear what you think. I really hope it's not a Tempestus kind of thing. I hope we are slowly going to progress the kits and slowly replace the old ones, but not make the old guard who have, you know, collected Orcs for like 10, 20 years or even longer feel obsolete within a day. That would be stupid. The last 2 points I wanted to mention are that we are getting a preview week next week as of the date of recording, and there are Orc banners in the preview picture, as you can see. So that means we will get more Orc stuff next week, and there are two previews next week, which for me indicates that one preview for 40k will be Orcs, and the other one will be Adeptus Auroratus with some other stuff sprinkled in, as always. That's my prediction, at least. Lastly, we also seen a preview of an Orc, and we are still not sure what it was, unless I'm missing something. You can see it on the screen right now. If we've already seen it, or if it's the Beast Snagger boy, please let me know, but I think we haven't seen it yet, and yeah, that still remains to be seen. A lot of people expected that this is the new Orc boys kit, but I somehow doubt that's going to happen now. But yeah, if you have any idea what that could be, let me know in the comments. And that's the whole video. Thanks for watching, and I see you in the next one. Bye-bye.